we just wait here.
Oh, you just
so
wait
when
here.
You when you finish.
You guys want
you
anything? I think
oh,
I have some
so
Gatorade
much.
Out in the park. Let me give you some Gatorade.
So we are. We can read the
binders to me or to you.
You know what? You go here.
Now which plants are going back?
One.
These
two? Yeah, those two. I would put back further.
No, I mean going back to the flora?
Yeah, those all of the plants.
Thank you so much. The metal looks great.
Good. Did you see this yet?
No. These flowers are to die for. Look at these. Oh my God, hydrangea. Oh, my favorite flower. Oh, how scary! Oh my God! Oh, they're gonna have to come up and take pictures after the ceremony.
I know, they'll have to figure that out, but.
What the?
They're live, they're sprayed.
Oh my God, it is spectacular.
I don't know if you wanna. I don't think you wanna know how much this costs.
I don't even wanna know, but I can only imagine what these flowers alone would cost. And if it's something like that, oh my goodness. Is Joanne here?
Yeah, she just went out.
She should see the beauty of what she
yeah,
did.
Yeah, we were just, because I wanted her, I said, you have any artistic?
Yeah, look at the top. Oh.
Thank you.
I'll wait for her. Yeah.
Okay.
We're running out of ideas.
Big leaf is going over there?
No.
The little leaf.
The little leaf. The big leaf is staying here.
No, that's got to go. That's not going
to
stay.
Yeah, so we're trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
So, what were you saying before, Dennis?
No, I think if it goes.
Receiving it up here.
We are.
Okay, so then they need to turn and take a picture. Okay,
if
so
anybody wants, yeah.
Put the plant right here.
And then you come down here and turn the banners over. Which will be available from the link.
That's old towers try to get them to give a little bit more distance. That's
yeah,
not
okay,
good.
That's
I tried
not good.
That.
Yeah.
They kind of
2020, you guys got it.
Yeah.
Okay,
good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, I didn't even recognize you. I love the hair.
I love the hair.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, ladies, for doing whatever it is that you're doing. You're doing
absolutely.
A lot.
Estamos en México, brother.
get somebody to move them up there.
Alright, let me get someone to help you.
Paper, scissors.
Thank you.
Thank you. One, two. Yeah. Yeah. One, two. Check. Yep. One, two. One, two, one, one, two, check.
Testing, one, two, testing. Can you guys hear me on the outside? Perfect. Good morning and congratulations.
So beautiful.
Yep, yep. Power on. One, two. All right.
Thank you.
check those?
Yeah. Morning.
Good morning. Would Asha and Sharon please report to the stage? Asha and Sharon, will you please report to the stage? Thank you. Jaheim Richards, please report to the stage. Once again, Jaheim Richards, please report to the stage.
Oh,
graduates. Good morning. Good morning, graduates, parents, family, and guests. We're going to begin in a moment. I just want to review some important things. First, always, everyone should have their masks on and be practicing social distancing. It's very important that we do everything we can to remain safe. As far as the graduates, each step of the graduation ceremony will explain what we're doing prior to you coming up on stage. All right, we're looking to have a great ceremony. So in a few moments, we will begin. Let's make this a memorable day. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. We are about to begin. At this time, I ask all the graduates, the class of 2020, to stand for the singing of our national anthem by Mr. Everett Wilson from the class of 1991.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson.
At this time, Brother Peter Bonventry will lead us in prayer.
God of the universe, we have lived with this dreaded pandemic, worried for ourselves, for our loved ones, and indeed for everyone on earth. For months, we have marched and shouted, Black Lives Matter. For months, we have felt the stress of the chaos in our city. And now we mourn the death of John Lewis. Where have you been, God? Maybe we have forgotten that we are always in the holy presence of God, and that you live life with us, worried with us, grieving with us, shouting with us. It has been a painful senior year. We have lost so many rituals that we were looking forward to. A sad time for our seniors. But right now, God, we will forget all that and concentrate on this joyous moment, our actual graduation. Soon we will hold that piece of paper that says that we have graduated after 4 years of listening to our parents and our teachers urge us, cajole us, even threaten us. Yes, we parents and teachers did that, and we are glad we did, because today we are proud of these young men and women. Their future is filled with wonderful possibilities. That the approach it in the years ahead with confidence in themselves and confidence in you. We recall the challenging words of President Barack Obama when in May he addressed the graduates of 2020. I hope you ground yourselves in values that last, like honesty, hard work, responsibility, fairness, generosity, respect for others. Isn't that what Lockwood taught these seniors? The president continued, it doesn't matter how much money you make, if everyone around you is hungry and sick, our society and democracy only works when we think not just about ourselves, but about each other. That is the gospel value that Bishop Lachlan tries to instill in every student. And now, God, we ask you to bless our seniors. May they always be surrounded with love, as they are at this moment, enfolded in the affection and warm good wishes of family, friends, and teachers. We ask this through Christ Jesus. Amen.
Brother Peter. Welcome, parents, family, friends, those watching at home. Welcome to the class of 2020's graduation, the 168th commencement in Lachlan's history. I'd like to recognize the people that are on stage. We have current board member Tom McLaughlin, former board member Brian Connolly, our school president, Brother Dennis Cronin, our assistant principal, Mrs. Cecilia Gottsagen, our freshman and junior dean, Mr. Luis Montes, and our senior dean, Mrs. Freeman. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce our salutatorian. Our salutatorian is a young lady who came to us from Trey Whitfield School. She finished high school with a 98.8 average. She is an active member of our school. She is a member of the National Honor Society. She participated in step and African dance. Her teachers describe her as humble, caring, and respectful. She is the model for meeting the standards we set for character, leadership, religious faith, and academic success. She is well-liked and respected by her peers. She was accepted to Adelphi University, Hofstra University, Siena College, Providence College, St. Lawrence University, Ithaca College. She will be attending Long Island University in the fall on an honors scholarship to study biochemistry. It is my pleasure to introduce the salutatorian for the class of 2020, Sharon Griffin.
For those who don't know, that is what we call the radiator on the first floor were closest to the A side. It is where my cousin Asher, our group of friends, Pedro, Chloe, Leanne, Lauren, Marquise, Kayla, and I, waited until we were ready to go home. People who passed by began to call us the Aviator Club, and we eventually got an official plaque. Memories like this will forever be shared, and we have that plaque in our minds. I know all of the other classmates have memories of their own that they will never forget. However, our graduation will not only be special to us, it will go down in history and will be remembered by everyone around the world. Our class will be known for continuing to use our determination to overcome any obstacle that tries to hinder our success. 2020 is a year of change, and we are the generation that will bring about that change. Whether it is within society, politics, medicine, arts, or anything that we are passionate about. As I begin to end this speech, I want to leave you all with one last thought. John Wooden once said, "Success comes from knowing that you did your best to become the best that you are capable of becoming." As you go out into the world to start a life of your own, make a promise to yourself that you will follow your passions and use your talents to advance the world and society around you. Promise to always try your best at anything you put your mind to. Never let anything change how you see yourself, and use your uniqueness to help the world, because in this room we always say, "We have entered locking to learn, and now we are leaving to serve." It is now our time to set the foundation for the future. Thank you again to the class of 2020, and congratulations.
At this point, I'd like to recognize some teachers who will be retiring. First, Deacon Bliss will be retiring at the end of this year after 16 years of teaching students in Auckland. Miss Jean Van Nelson will be retiring after teaching math and serving as our chairperson for the last 38 years. The great Lou Maffei will be retiring after 42 years. But we're really not going to let him go away. He's going to be here every day anyway. Now, yesterday we received some bad news about an alum, a teacher, a former teacher, and legendary track coach, Mr. Edwin J.J. Mose. He passed away just shy of his 78th birthday. I'd ask for a moment of silence in his memory. Thank you. Now, Mr. Bowes would be mad at me for doing anything to dampen the spirit of the ceremony. He had a great passion for life and a love for Auckland students, and he will be missed, but he will have a great day. At this time, Mrs. Gottsagen will announce the academic awards for the class of 2020.
First honor, the Oscar Griffin. the Art Award for second honor, Mr. Ron Perkins. I'm sorry. And first honor, the Ashley Vito. English, second honor, Sharon Griffith. First honor, Oscar Griffith. In the Romance Language Department, Spanish, second honor, Jason Noel. Spanish, first honor, Juliette R. Penner. French, second honor, Shanella Lovelace. And first honor, Alan Verwain. Mathematics, second honor, Austin Griffith. First honor, Sharon Griffith. In music, second honor, Marquise Ellis. Music, first honor, Joshua James. Science, second honor, Sharon Griffith. Science, first honor, Asha Griffith. Social studies, second honor, Adrian Lewis. First honor, Asha Griffith. The brother, Rachel Cicini, Award for Christian Witness, Nosema Salami. Also, during our senior class day, we would have also awarded plaques and certificates to students. So when you make your way for those class day awards, please join the academic people standing. The award for perfect attendance for a full year, never absent, never late, Alan Verwain. Students that have earned advanced designation Regents Diploma. Leanne Iris Henry, Thomas Stiles, Kevin Duran, Ariel Frazier, Jeremiah Bradenheit, Asha Griffith, Sharon Griffith, Maximus Perot, Naomi Henry, Liz Moran, Andrew May, Shalia Nick, Jason Noel, Nosema Salami, Sheldon Sanders, Alan Verwain, Morgan West, and Malik Williams. Congratulations. The Diocese of Brooklyn, the Covenant Award goes to Asha Griffith. The St. LaSalle Medal for Academic Improvement, donated by the Christian Brothers. To get this award, your average has to go up every year, starting the freshman year all the way through and the senior year. That is awarded to Naima Walker. The Athletic Director's Award for Academic Excellence is to Shania Labros. The Nugent Brothers Trophy for Exemplary Christian Character and Athletic Achievement, Adina Palma and Aguilar Sai. The Vincent Maddox Award, donated by Jim Reynolds, to Brianna White. The Dr. Robert Lucia Grosso Award, to Marquise Ellis. Holy Award for Mercy and Compassion. Azul Dulceron. Students that have earned honest grades in Project Lead the Way. Malik Williams, Alex Anderson, Ashley Rowe, Maximus Harrell, Adrian Lewis, Jameen Begin, Isaiah Mann Christian. The Borough President's Graduation Award. Asha Griffith for Academic Excellence, Cyrus Blake for I Am Possible, and Maria Caraco for One Brooklyn. The University of Rochester Faust and Lowell Award to Asha Griffith. The University of Rochester Xerox Award to Calvin Nicely. The University of Rochester Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony Award to Naomi Henry. The University of Rochester George Eastman Young Leaders Award, Marquis Ellis. The District Attorney Certificate of Excellence to Pedro Bucheron and Nelson Mascolano. The Attorney General Trickle State Award to Isaiah Mann Christian and Alan Romain. The Public Advocate Award to Chloe Innes. The New York State Controllers Award to Shania Negros and Morgan West. The New York City Controllers Award to Shalia Nick and Amber Webb. The Center for Dallas Music Award donated by the United States Marines to Amir Brown, Todd Carter, Sheldon Stratton, and Nicholas Ramsey. The New York Blood Drive Scholarship to Nostrad Salami. And finally, the Parent Association Senior Hall of Fame. Amir Brown, Natalie Dennis, Yoko Joe, Adrian Lewis, Danielle Loco, and Nicola Oxford. Congratulations. Those children, please take your parents, and then you may be seated.
At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce our valedictorian. Our valedictorian is a young lady who came to us from Trey Whitfield School. She finished high school with a 99 average. She's a member of the National Honor Society. She played the flute in the band. She participated in the LaSallian Youth, and she also has the highest rank. She is also the highest ranking graduate of the Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health at Downstate Medical College. Her teachers describe her as humble, respectful, and caring. She is well liked and respected by her peers. She was accepted at Boston University, New York University, Providence College, SUNY Albany, SUNY Buffalo, SUNY Stony Brook, Penn State, Adelphi University. She will be attending Long Island University on a Presidential Scholarship and a major in biology. It is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2020, Asha Griffith.
Thank you.
For some of you, this is the first time I'm hearing this speech. So I advise you to take it. Today is our graduation day. It has time to come. Several months ago, our next group was stressing over a classroom and trying to be on time for school. Now, we would have never imagined that this would be the end of our high school careers. The coronavirus has derailed plans and canceled events that we have been looking forward to for 4 years. But by the grace of God, we are here today, and we are not disheartened.
Not about COVID-19. This ceremony is about 3 years and 5.5 months of mastering challenging academic work, practicing hard and playing well, pursuing interests and forging friendships. This ceremony is about celebrating you, the class of 2020, and your accomplishments. What you were able to achieve, you did not achieve alone. You succeeded to the extent you did with the support of your family, your teachers, and your friends. They loved you and challenged you. Lachlan shared its traditions, its values, and ethos of faith, service, and community. On all of those who have gone before you. Men and women of Auckland, proud women of Bishop McDonald, Lancers from St. Augustine, they have given their time and their talent and their treasure. In your class alone, over these past 4 years, they have contributed in excess of $1.5 million in scholarship and tuition assistance for this class. Please, remember the words from St. Luke's Gospel. To whom much is given, much is expected. When your time comes, remember to pay it forward. Remember the next generation of Bostonites who will need and deserve your time, your talent, and your treasure. During this time, I was reminded of a poem which I enjoy calling The Journey of the Magi. It reframes the famous story of the wise men who searched out the child that was born in Bethlehem. When one of the Magi returns home, he says, this set down, this. Were we led all that way for birth or death? But had thought they were different. We returned to our palaces, our places, but no longer at ease here, in those dispensations. Together, this year in particular, we've been on a journey framed dramatically this summer, where we confronted as a nation death, George Floyd. And that man's death called men, people who are black, and people who are brown, and people who are white, they called men to once again to the idea of justice for all, justice founded on peace. No longer comfortable with the old dispensation. And I'd like to end by quoting John Lewis, who wrote an op-ed piece that appeared in the New York Times upon his death. And he ends his comment by saying this to all of us, but particularly when historians pick up their pens to write the story of the 21st century, let them say that it was your generation
who laid down the heavy burdens of faith at last. And that peace finally triumphed over violence, aggression, and war. So I say to you, walk with the wind, brothers and sisters, and let the spirit of peace and the power of everlasting love be your guide. At Bishop Laughlin, we begin our day, we end our day with a simple phrase. May you carry this in your heart forever. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. Congratulations, men and women of God.
Thank you, Brother Dennis.
At this point, I'm the only thing that stands away from getting the phone. Graduation has always been a great day, and it's a day we look forward to, it's a day we celebrate, it's a day that's important to our parents, our graduates, our community. And this graduation is like none we've ever had before. And I'm going to just include two thoughts in my discussion this morning. First is perseverance. I often tell the story at graduation. My father was a fife poet in the 60s, and his most famous client was Floyd Patterson, the first two-time heavy champion in the world. Now, Floyd was a light heavyweight. He wasn't exactly a large man. And he's the first one to regain the title, something that Ali did after him. But he had a propensity to get knocked down often. And toward the end of his career, a smart aleck reporter asked him, how does it feel to be a heavyweight champion to be knocked down most often? And he looked at the reporter in the eye and said, great. Because if I'm the heavyweight champion, I've got up the most. Folks, you've dealt with a tremendous amount of adversity throughout the past 4 years, particularly the last 4 months. But it has been your grit, your determination, your unwillingness to quit that gets us to where we are today. We have, for the first time at a graduation, a 100% graduation rate. This group collectively has earned over $20 million in college scholarships. And I want to move to my second point, and that's about reflection. And you know, I always like to talk about pizza and how high school is like pizza, and that we have eight slices and eight classes. And I think the last time we were together, I showed the slide with one slice left for the class of 2020. And I can honestly say we have the worst last slice of pizza of any class in our school's history. You have dealt with terrible things and had to give up so much. No problem. All the senior activities. We have a number of tremendous athletes out here who did not get to compete. Our Lady Lions track team, the relay team, who knows what they could have accomplished. And we can sit here and dwell on what we lost. Or we can be thankful for what we have. And I think it's important that you are thankful for what you have. First, be thankful for your parents. Your parents have sacrificed to send you here, and they care about you, and they have invested in your future. Great things. So let's thank our parents. And certainly, we have to thank each other. We have to thank each other for being there for all 4 years, for helping each other through all those different moments. Whether it was in the classroom, studying the biomedical program, the engineering program, all the AP classes, or struggling to prepare for Regents.
You guys did that together. Collectively, you all both received your diplomas as a group together. An amazing accomplishment. And last but not least, let us thank our teachers who have been touching our hearts and minds for 4 years. A round of applause to them. Now, I would be absolutely remiss if we did not give a big round of applause for our senior dean, the glue to our school, Miss Nikki Freeman.
Graduates and parents, what a special day it is, and it is with great pleasure that today myself, my partner Mr. Montes, will be the name and he will receive your high school diploma. This will be when you call the homeroom, you will ask and we will thankfully be our usher. Will come, line here, walk across, and on camera. We're blessed with a photographer and our parents association that will give you an announcement and a rose for your parents. So, with no further ado, will the homeroom of 105 please stand? Thank you. Deshaun Dewar.
Thank you.
Lamar Huggins. Bianca Rowe, member of the National Honor Society. Thank you. Marcus Chin.
Thank you.
Brianna Payne.
Thank you.
Cyrus Lloyd.
Amir Brown, member of the National Honor Society.
Thank you.
led by another social studies teacher, Mr. Richard McGuire. We begin with Ashley Eno, member of the National Honor Society.
Thank you.
Warren Stewart.
This time we're going to have Mr. Wilson sing our school song.
Please rise.